Anand Vijay. In this video lecture, we have revised the portion that are a portion there questions you have faced in online PT3 examination. So we start with the fill in the blanks. Why the fill in the blanks? Because the fill in the blanks questions are also converted into the MCQ format. Maybe you can find the whatever the MCQ question, maybe it's there is a fill in the blanks. And so the true false is there the question may be converted into the MCQ format. So guys, we start with the working with layers, your chapters for the PT3 examinations. And we start fill in the blanks. The first, the answer is also given. I explore the answers here with the details. Layers are the like multiple dash sheet can be hold the object or stacked onto top of each other. That is the transparent. Because the layers are the transparent. There is the one sheet and it contains the different layers. And each layer contains the different drawings. Each layer contains the different drawing. And all are visible at a time onto the same stage. Why? Because the layer are transparent. Due to transparency of layers, all the elements are visible onto the stage. So the first transparent is right answer. The active layer in the timeline is indicated with keyframe navigation controller icon. Whatever the layer you are working, that is the active, and it can be represented by the keyframe navigation controller icon. The next one, when you take an object out of the library, the object is referred as instance. Instance of the symbol, that means instance is the representation of the real original drawing. Whatever the animation you have created is the copy of that one. That is called the instance. Okay. So library panel always contains the instance. Now come onto the to display the grid onto the stage. Select view. You move onto the view, then grid and show grid option. There is the view menu in the animation software. And then you have choose the grid option. Under grid there is the show grid. The whole stage can be show with the small grid line, horizontal and vertical cross mark of grid. Okay, the next one, dash is an object act as a hole through the we see the contents of a layers or a layers beneath it, that means inside it. Mask, the answer is the mask. Mask is the object that allow to whatever the contains, whatever the drawing is, drawing contains the another drawing inside the push hole. Which kind of drawing it can be contained? That is the mask. Okay. Now come on to the true false. In animate, only one layer can be active at a time. Yes, that is the true. Only one layer. Not all layers are active at a time. You can convert an object symbols by using F8 key. That is also true. It can be by pressing F8 key. Whatever the drawing you have visible onto the stage, it automatically converted into the symbols. And we can use again and again that particular drawing because it is already in the symbol form. The speed of animation can be adjusted in bokeh or node. It can be adjusted in property panel. So this option is the false. Masking hides the other parts and show only those part and image that appear underneath the object on which we are applying the masking effect. That is true. Where you can apply the masking, it only show the essential part of the image. Okay, and the unwanted parts are hide there. Then an animation cannot be represented more than once. False. We can represent it more and more time as per requirement. A single animation can be repeated again and again. Next, there is the MCQ. Which tool allow you to see the faint ghost image in the previous frame? That is the onion skin option. By using onion skin, the image is look like a washout mode and it is called the faint ghost image, and the same copy of the image will be displayed in the washout mode. That is also known as faint ghost. Which option is used to repeat the animation? That is the control loop. animation, that is the control loop playback. By using this option, the once animated things are start from the beginning, then move to the end. Again, it restart from the beginning. Again, it move to the end. Again, this process will be occurred again and again. That why? Because the loop playback will be enabled there. Okay, so control loop playback, we can repeat the same animation again and again. Which key combination can group the object in animate? That is the control G. By using control G, we can group all the image. Okay, the last one, which key will be used? Which key will use? Will you press to insert a keyframe? That is the F6 key. F6 key. Basically, the keyframe is the special kind of frame that can be used to change the positioning of the object. That means the drawing. So, by using F6 key, F6 function key, we can insert a new keyframe inside it. So, that's all for today. For the today, in this video lecture, it is the complete revision portion, and in next video lecture we have revised the next chapter, introduction to HTML5. Thank you and have a good day.